This is the top of the village now. And that's the view that greets you. Well, as you can see, we made it down into the harbour at Clovelly, thanks to the hyperlapse, 5 times speeded up of our journey down through the village. Mandy's gone on to the pier over there. I'm heading out to a waterfall, and over there's a big waterfall. I'm going to go and see that. There's that waterfall, and the closer I get to it, the more magnificent it looks. We've had a lot of water lately, so it's in full spate. Bit tricky going on the feet. I can feel the mist from the waterfall. Wow, look at that. I don't know if the camera's doing it justice. There's a lot of water thundering down there. It's not until you get close to the actual waterfall itself you can feel the air, the downdraft of air and the mist and spray, which is extending several tens of metres either side of the waterfall. Yes, the powerful force of nature, that for sure. Here's another look at the harbour, looking over to the Red Lion, and that's just stood on the ramp of the lifeboat. Leaving the harbour area now, heading back up the hill. This time we'll call in and see a few little sights on the way up. first cabins or shelters we've come across, with outstanding views across Bideford Bay. We'll take a closer look at the cabin. Thought I might find you sat in here.
I'm lovely. You sit here, Sandy, you can see. Sit here, see what we've got. Beautiful.
This shelter was known as the Angel's Wings. It was built in 1826, can you believe? It was placed as a shelter for the original owner, Sir James Hamlin Williams, I believe. Who could sit here and look across Bideford Bay to where his daughter used to live.
It's hot.
We've got to a permissive path now, which takes us to a piece of high ground called the lookout. So we're going to go and have a look at the lookout, and then we're going to come back down this path and then go to the actual cove itself. But it's a very pleasant path indeed to walk along. the island of Lundy.
Nice.
So this is Mouth Mill Cove, and these are the limestone kilns or limestone workings.